Good afternoon and welcome to Cardington Lincoln High School's 124th Annual Commencement Ceremony. Please welcome Elizabeth Long, Junior Class President, as she leads us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and with liberty and justice for all.
I would like to welcome you again, faculty and guests, staff, friends, families, and honored graduates of the class of 2020. Welcome to Cardington Lincoln High School's commencement ceremony. Thank you for joining us this afternoon, and thank you for providing the support and guidance that has fostered the success of these fine young men and women. Our graduates today will be remembered for their senior year as different, but my hope is that they will have memories of a lifetime of us working together and achieving the goal to overcome the devastating results of the COVID-19 virus. Today, I'm going to ask you to forget about goals. Focus on systems instead. This is taken from James Clear's book, Atomic Habits. Prevailing wisdom claims that the best way to achieve what we want in life, getting into better shape, building a successful business, relaxing more, spending more time with friends and family, is to set specific actionable goals. For many years, this was how I approached my habits as well. Each one was a goal to be reached. Goals are about the results you want to achieve. Systems are about the processes that lead to those results. If you're a coach, your goal might be to win a championship. Your system is the way you recruit players, manage your assistants, and conduct practice. Now for the interesting question. If you completely ignored your goals and focused only on your system, would you still succeed? For example, if you were a basketball coach and you ignored your goal to win a championship and focused only on what your team does at practice each day, would you still get results? Yes, you would. Goals are good for setting a direction, but systems are best for making progress. Three things to think about when considering picking a system over goals. One, winners and losers have the same goal. Two, achieving a goal is only a momentary change. Three, goals restrict your happiness. When you fall in love with the process rather than the product, you don't have to wait to give yourself permission to be happy. You can't be satisfied anytime. You can be satisfied anytime your system is running. And a system can be successful in many different forms, not just one for your first envision. Seniors, I challenge you to set and update your goals, but more importantly, I challenge you to create systems that would prove you a lifetime of success. Graduates, you all should be very proud of your achievements we are honoring today. Congratulations, savor the memory, and enjoy the ceremony. And always remember, the choice is yours. Please welcome Ms. Wallet for the introduction of our salutatorian.
It is no secret that in the last 3 months, our lifestyle has changed. The vision that the class of 2020 had for their senior year was washed away with the single pass of a Lysol can. We've gotten used to hearing new words on our TV screen. Words like pandemic, closures, contagious. Some of us feared visiting with loved ones because we were afraid we might give them something. Some of us feared going to grocery stores because we were afraid we might come into contact with someone who was infectious. We washed and scrubbed surfaces because we didn't want any trace of the virus left behind. Words like contagious have left a negative taste in our mouth. But like most other things that our first speaker encounters, she leaves us with a reminder of how contagious can be positive. She is not afraid to give to others, to serve them in whatever way she can. She is not afraid to be infected with the good and happy things in life, with knowledge or with strength. and she has left a lasting impact in her school and community, one that cannot be simply wiped away, the trace of which will linger long after she has left these halls. I first met Grace Struck when she fluttered into my classroom as a freshman, and I truly mean fluttered, as her contagious personality and bright smile truly infect any room that she enters in the best way possible. Throughout that first year, she showed such strength and confidence in everything that she did. She knew what she wanted and she pursued it hard, while treating anyone and everyone in her path with Disney princess level kindness. I knew then that she would accomplish quite literally anything she set her mind to, and I still believe that today. Grace is strong and fierce, yet kind and inclusive. She is brilliant and polished, yet fun and carefree. She is a defender of the weak and an advocate for her passions. It has been my true honor to watch Grace grow in her faith and become a light in a world that has become so dark. Grace shines that light fearlessly, and by doing so, truly allows and encourages others to do the same. I have no doubt that she will surely infect the world and leave her trace wherever she goes with her utterly contagious personality, and that she will be a phenomenal representation of our school and community. It is my honor to introduce the class president and salutatorian of the Cardington High School class of 2020, Miss Grace Struck.
Thank you, Miss Wallett, for that introduction. And thank you for being such an amazing mentor to me throughout high school. I appreciate everything you have done and continue to do for me. Good afternoon, everyone. As previously stated by Miss Wallett, I am Grace Struck, the salutatorian for the class of 2020. I am honored to be speaking here today. Parents, we are finally here. Just yesterday, you sent us off to our first day of school. 12 years later, and we are before you as soon-to-be high school graduates. Class of 2020, it is hard to believe today is the day we have all been waiting for, the day we graduate. It seems like just yesterday we were in our kindergarten classrooms learning the most basic things. It seems like just yesterday times were so much simpler. All of us have changed so much from then until now. We have found ourselves here, and most of us have discovered what we want our next steps to be. Some of us are undecided and do not know where life is going to take us next, but considering we have all made it this far, it is safe to say eventually we will find out. To start out, I just want to say a couple of thank yous. Thank you to my parents for always believing in me, especially when I didn't believe in myself. I would not be the person I am today without your guidance. Thank you to my siblings, Noah and Ella, for always being there for me when I needed you the most. Thank you to my grandparents, aunts, uncles, and cousins for all of your constant support. Thank you to my teachers for always pushing me to the best of my ability. Thank you to all of my friends for always supporting me in everything I do. Thank you to everyone who has ever impacted my life in any way. In class of 2020, thank you for all of the memories that I will cherish forever. Before high school started, I was terrified to speak in front of people. Presentations made me sick to my stomach. In fact, they still do. But here we are, and here I am, speaking to all of you. I have wanted to speak at my graduation ceremony since I was in grade school. I remember sitting on my floor, writing a random piece of paper, and starting my graduation speech. If random thoughts came to me regarding my speech, I would write them down and stick them with the first piece of paper. I found those papers recently, and the main message of my speech was that life is confusing. My first thought was that life is confusing was a strange topic to discuss at a high school graduation. That was not the type of message I was expecting to find. In my head, I thought it was going to be this amazing and powerful speech, and that I didn't have to think too hard on a topic. I guess my grade school self thought it was extremely important to talk at graduation about how life is confusing. Originally, I had this big plan to talk about the speech I had written in grade school, but after finding that did not look like it was going to happen. So recently, I stumbled across the phrase overcoming obstacles, which in a sense relates to our senior year and what we have been doing our entire lives, overcoming obstacles that have gotten in our way to get to this very moment, graduation. We have gotten through grade school, junior high, and now high school. We have done it. We have overcome all obstacles that tried to stop us from getting here. Considering the circumstances of this speech, we are still overcoming these obstacles. We are the only senior class to have to go online for almost the entire second half of our senior year. This pandemic is making it difficult for seniors everywhere to have a normal senior year and a normal graduation. While our senior year has been nothing but normal, we are still overcoming it every single day. We wake up every day and go about our lives with this new normal, which, in a sense, goes back to my original plan of my grade school speech. The end of our senior year was not at all what we were expecting. We expected to have this amazing senior year with lots of memories and fun adventures that we would cherish for the rest of our lives. We did not expect it to be filled with online learning and quarantine, but that was the year we received. Even though we find ourselves graduating in an unideal circumstance, we have all worked so hard for this moment. It seems like everything is working against us to have our moment. This very special day is changed into something so different. All of us were looking forward to so much this year. Our last sports season, our last prom, our last May Day, our last banquets, our last memories together. None of these things happened the way we planned them to. And why is this happening to us? I'm not sure. Life is very confusing. I just thought I would throw that sentence in there because honestly, my speech about how life is confusing does relate to what is happening with all of us right now. These times are confusing and uncertain, and that is why we need to continue to overcome every obstacle with an optimistic outlook on how things can and will turn around. Stores are reopening, restaurants are allowing people to come inside and eat. Things are starting to go back to normal. We are overcoming the obstacle. Although we may feel like everything is working against us, it does not take away the fact that we have overcome this year. Basically, the moral of this speech is that we have done it. We made it here. We are about to be Cardington alumni. Even though it seemed like everything was going against us, nothing can take away how we feel in this moment. I cannot wait to see all of the amazing things every single one of you do in your future endeavors. Congratulations to you all. I am so glad to be graduating with all of you. Thank you, Cardington, for providing me with the opportunity to grow in such an amazing community. Thank you to everyone watching this today. Congratulations, Cardington Class of 2020.
Welcome, Mr. Byerly, for the introduction of our valedictorian.
It is my honor and privilege to announce Emily Benson to the class of 2020. Emily asked me to do this for her, and I thought that is a fantastic idea. I have loved working with Emily very much over the last several years here in high school. We have crossed paths several times in math classes, improv, and otherwise. One of the nice things about improv that I work with Emily in is the ability to get up, stand up, and work with what you have. For those of you that don't know, improv is basically acting without a script. Life is improv. You don't typically have a how do I interact with my boss script that you work with. So one of the problems with improv, however, is it doesn't help you with your memory. There are lots of things that you always want to say, and sometimes you just forget. I have a script up here of all the important things that I really want to say about Emily because she's so fantastic, but I promise you, when I sit down, I'm going to find five notes on this list that I totally forgot to say of things that I could brag about Emily. And that is unfortunate, but that's how it goes. When Emily asked me to speak, I asked her, well, you know, give me all the fun stuff, all the great things that we get to brag about. And she mentioned that she had done a senior spotlight for Mrs. Price, who put all those together to brag about each of the kids. So I got a hold of Emily's, and I was looking at Emily's, and I have it here. Emily is looking forward to studying nursing at Mount Vernon. That's super exciting. She's also, it says here, has been a member of Honor Society, Spanish Club, Spirit Club, the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, Varsity Cheer, and has been a class officer for 4 years. Certainly an exhaustive list of the who's who and the what's what of clubs here at Cardington. Except for improv, the reason why I'm introducing her. But I don't hold that against her. There are a lot of times that you forget things that are important, and I'm going to pretend like improv might have been one of those things. All the time, you see actors get up and they thank everybody else in the cast and the producers and the Lord and everybody that they think of mentioning. They forget their moms. They forget their wives. It happens all the time. So, moving forward, class of 2020, one of the messages that I want to make sure that Emily and the rest of you understand is that there are going to be a lot of times that you're going to forget the important people that have helped you get to where you are today and moving forward. And you are going to have some rough days ahead of you. You thought the tail end of this year was a little weird and a little rough for you. It's nothing. Trust me, there will be more days when you wish you were back here at school and you had the support system that you currently have. So think about that as you go off on your own. Again, Emily mentioned she wants to be a nurse. Nursing is perhaps the most overlooked profession other than teaching that you could possibly go into. Everybody comes to you with a problem, and they expect you to focus on them and to fix what's going on with them. And that's very important. And there are going to be days when that's going to travel with you and you're going to go home with that and you're going to feel the weight of the world on your shoulders. Other seniors, maybe it's not nursing. Whatever it is that is you, you are going to feel the weight of the world on your shoulders. And it's important for you to remember that you do have a support system. Whether that ends up being a significant other, whether that's your parents, or whether it's all the teachers that got you to this point today, please remember that just because you're graduating doesn't mean that you're leaving forever. It just means that you're changing your overall structure. And maybe Mrs. Klinger can't nag you every day to get that paper in, and maybe Mr. Byerly can't catch you in the hallway and remind you of that test you have to take. But you still have support. When you need it, please remember that your teachers, your parents, and your loved ones are still there for you. With that, I would like to officially announce Emily Benson, your valedictorian for the class of 2020.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before I begin, I would like to start by saying some thank yous. First, thank you to the community of Cardington and all of the staff and teachers for making today possible and for doing so much for us and trying your best to make our senior year as great and as normal as possible. We appreciate it more than you know. Next, I want to say thank you to my fellow classmates for making these past 12 years the most fun and memorable years of my life. I really couldn't ask for better or crazier classmates and friends. And a special thank you to my best friends, Ashley, Grace, Isabel, Aaliyah, and Cameron, for always supporting me no matter what. I am beyond thankful for you. I want to thank Spencer, Megan, my grandparents, and other family members for always being there for me and challenging me to be the best version of myself and encouraging me to follow my dreams. I want to thank God for giving me the strength and perseverance to overcome adversity and to accomplish all my goals. With Him, all things are possible. Lastly, I want to thank my mom and dad. Thank you for never giving up on me, even when I made it hard for you. Thank you for everything you've done to help me reach my goals. Thank you for believing in me when I had trouble believing in myself. I owe all of my success to you. I love you endlessly. Now, I will tell you a story. My name is Emily Benson, and 4 very short years ago, I, along with all of my classmates, walked into Cardington Lincoln High School as high school students for the first time. and we've been waiting for graduation day ever since. But before we receive our diplomas and turn our tassels, I'd like to share with you a few stories and a few things I've learned from my journey here at CHS. Let's start with freshman year. Like most freshmen, we were timid, scared of the upperclassmen, and just trying to remember where our classes were. But as Mrs. Conley and Mrs. Wells can attest to, that didn't last long. We learned that Romeo and Juliet isn't nearly as romantic as we thought it would be, and grammar book would be the key to getting extra credit in English. We learned all about how high school works. We learned who sits where in the cafeteria, and which teachers you could and could not convince to not to mark you tardy for the third time this week. But most importantly, we learned to come out of our comfort zones. Freshman year is the year of choices and opportunities. As we became involved in sports and clubs with so many different types of people, with ages from 15 to 18, we learned to branch out. Freshman year taught us how to try new things, even if they seem scary. Now to sophomore year. The best part about being a sophomore is that you are no longer a freshman. Sophomore year, we finally felt like high schoolers. And the best part for us, but the scariest part for everyone else, we learned how to drive. Sophomore year was a year of new experiences. As a class, we won May Day, and we grew closer together because of it. And sophomore year, I stepped out of my comfort zone and tried out for the improv team. This may or may not have been the best decision I made in high school. After our last show of the year, we all sat patiently in Mr. Byerly's room, waiting to hear what he did and didn't like about our last show. Now at the time, he and everyone else believed this would be his last improv show ever. So when he came in to talk to us, he said, "No matter where you go in life, remember to give a gift to whoever you're around, because when it comes down to it, life is much more about what you have contributed than what you have received." Now the term give a gift is improv slang that basically means in a scene you want to give information and details about the scene to the other characters to make it more harmonious. This statement sat in my head for many days to come. In high school, it's easy to worry about the trivial things. What brand of clothes you wear, what kind of car you drive, and so on and so forth. But in the end, none of that really matters, because no one is going to remember the clothes you wore or the car you drove. But they will remember how you made them feel. So in life, when you have the choice to give a gift and be kind, or to walk away, I hope that you choose kindness. That brings us to junior year. Junior year was the year of hard truths. We learned that Mrs. Klinger's Honors English 11 is not for the weak-willed, and I think the current juniors can back me up on that one. I remember the first day back in English class after Thanksgiving break. We were supposed to have read the 10-page Sleepy Hollow packet so we could talk about it when we came back to class. Well, long story short, we didn't. And when she tried to have in-class discussion about it and nobody said a word, we were toast. The next day, we had a 10-question pop quiz over the packet. And might I add, it wasn't multiple choice. First hard truth of the year. You can't BS your way through a 10-question short answer pop quiz. Just read the packet when you're supposed to. Later that year, not only did we have to take the ACT test, but also our state test and AP tests and final exams all within the span of 3 months. Now, after hearing this news, we were all complaining about it for weeks until finally Mrs. Price said, "It doesn't matter how much you complain about it, it's not going away." And that right there is hard truth number two. Life isn't fair, and sometimes you're hit with a tornado of work and tests and problems all at once, and all you can do is take it one day at a time. Only you can change your situation. So instead of complaining about it, work your hardest and make the best out of the situation. Finally, our senior year, the year of what should have been the best days of our lives. The year that should have held our last prom. The year the softball team should have gone to state yet again. The year we should have been here, all of us together, celebrating our hard work and determination that we've put forth the past 4 years. This isn't how things were supposed to go. In the book of Job, chapter 23, verse 10, It says, "But he knows where I'm going, and when he tests me, I will come out as pure gold." I could stand here all day and talk about how the virus ruined our senior year. But what would that change? God has a plan for each and every one of us, and adversity and hardships are part of those plans. He assures us that we will come out better and stronger people because of this. Now, with that being said, I'd like to focus on the positive things that have come out of all of this. After all, life is all about perspective. First, the virus taught us that life is truly unpredictable. I don't know about all of you, but I'm a planner. I had my whole life planned out for the next 4 years, and I knew exactly how it was going to go. And then real life happened. The moral here is that you never know what's going to happen next week, next month, or next year. So do the thing you've been wanting to do for so long, but haven't, because there's always tomorrow. Because you never know what tomorrow will bring, or if there will even be a tomorrow. Another important term you learn in improv is no negation, which means you can't say no. This can easily be applied to our new normal lives as we remember to embrace opportunity rather than immediately say no to something new because we're either scared or unsure. So buy the dress, eat the cookie, talk to the boy, go skydiving. Whatever it is, do it before it's too late. The second and most important thing the virus has taught us is to cherish every single moment. Junior prom was our last prom. Junior year was the last year for the baseball and softball players to play the game they love. Junior year was the last year for Grace, Abby, and Chantress to be in a musical. We had no idea. But going forward from this, I hope you never take for granted the time you spend doing the things you love, like acting in the musicals, dancing with your friends, or playing catch with your teammates. I hope you never take for granted the time you spend with your loved ones. I hope you call your grandparents. I hope you visit your cousins, and I hope you never hang up the phone without saying I love you to the person on the other line. This virus has taken a lot from us and others, but I pray we see it more as lessons learned than as times taken away. As Martin Luther King once said, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that." Remember that even in times of darkness and uncertainty, there is still goodness and light to be found. Choose to be the light. Choose to love one another. Class of 2020, as we go on from here, I pray you stay true to yourself and remember that each moment, no matter how small, matters. Remember that life will have its ups and downs, but nothing is too hard for you to overcome. I'm blessed to be a part of your journey, and I thank you for being a part of mine. Thank you.
Welcome our school counselor, Mr. Jamal, as he recognizes our top 10 academic students for the class of 2020.
Before I begin the top 10 list, I want to congratulate all of the graduating seniors for their hard work and dedication over these past 4 years. Getting to the end has been challenging, especially this last quarter and a half, but you did it. And now, the Cardington High School Class of 2020 top 10 list. Number 10, Liam Warren. Number 9, Ashley Morales. Number 8, Emma Burchett. Number 7, Kirsten George. Number 6, Andrew Chapelrai. Number 5, Rihanna Roth. Number 4, Hannah Wickline. Number 3, Casey Bertke. Number 2, Grace Struck. And number 1, Emily Benson. Again, congratulations on your academic achievements, and I wish you the best of luck in the next chapter of your lives. Thank you.
Cardington-Lincoln Superintendent Brian Petrie will announce our scholarship award winners and our commitments to the armed forces.
Thank you, Mr. Mills. Traditionally, I've used this platform to ask current and former members of the United States Armed Forces, to be recognized. In place of that this year, and under current circumstances, I challenge our community and students to find ways to reach out to our men and women who serve and have served our country in a time where some may be isolated and needing support. Please help me now in recognizing three Cardington seniors who will be joining the long list of Cardington students joining the military. Nick McAvoy will be entering the Army National Guard. Bryden Ratliff will be in the ROTC Army. And Connor Shinneberry will be entering the U.S. Marines. Less than 2 weeks ago, we had a senior cruise in place of our traditional senior walk at the elementary. Instead of standing in the crowd, I chose to drive as the last car. Along the route, it was great to hear families, friends, and alumni, past and present, say congratulations to our graduating seniors. Not far in, I started to hear, "Congratulations, oh, it's Mr. Petrie. Aren't you a little too old to be a graduate?" Instead of being embarrassed, it made me think, I've graduated 13 times, counting the graduations that I've had personally, 10 of them here. I thought more, how lucky am I to be a part of this moment each year for all of you. I truly do feel lucky to have been a part of your lives. Thank you for keeping us young. I'll leave you with this. In August, I met with our staff at our opening breakfast and shared this to start the year. I said, "Make it your best, ... the three ellipses." Well, what is an ellipsis? It's kind of a holding pattern. What this means to me is that you have a chance every day, and in fact, in any moment, to press pause, regardless of the past, and do your best in the next moment forward. Make it your best. Make it your best day of class. Make it your best day of work. Make it your best phone call or text to your friend. Make it your best and take that opportunity to perhaps turn things around. When things restart again, in a country founded on new starts, make it your best. Thank you. Each year, I have the honor of announcing scholarships for graduating seniors. Before recognizing them, I would like to take a moment to thank all of our local and regional donors whose sacrifice helps make the dreams of college a reality for our seniors. This year's scholarship recipients are Emily Benson, Mount Vernon Nazarene University, MVNU Heritage Scholarship, $16,500, Burr Farm Scholarship, $1,500, Cardington Board of Education Scholarship, $1,500, Frank and Lucille Ebert Scholarship, Valedictorian, $500, K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250, Kenneth and Louise Strine Memorial Scholarship, $10,000. Morrow County Professional and Business Women's Scholarship, $1,250. And the Seth Maseko Snuggletime Scholarship, $100. Grace Struck, Bowling Green State University. Bowling Green University Merit Scholarship, $6,000. Consolidated Electric Scholarship, $3,000. Cardington Lincoln Athletic Boosters Scholarship, $500. Frank and Lucille Ebert Scholarship Salutatorian, $500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. Kenneth and Louise Strine Memorial Scholarship, $10,000. McGinnis Family Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Mills Poorman Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. And the Morrow County Professional and Business Women's Scholarship, $1,250. Bailey Adams, Ohio Dominican Softball Scholarship, $6,000. Ohio Dominican Merit Scholarship, $15,000. And the Ohio Dominican Grant, $1,000. Casey Berkey, Cedarville University Dean's Excellence Scholarship, $11,500. Cedarville University Basketball Scholarship, $15,000. Cedarville University Softball Scholarship, $10,000. Cardington Lincoln Athletic Scholarship, $500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. Margaret Miller Memorial Scholarship, $10,000. And the Seth Maseko Snuggletime Scholarship, $250. Emma Burchett, Federal Pell Grant, $5,395. President's Affordability Grant, $2,250. Scarlet and Gray Grant, $5,750. Cardington Farm Association Scholarship, $750. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. And the Margaret Miller Memorial Scholarship, $10,000. Madeline Carson Cook, Cardington Music Boosters Scholarship, $500. Chantress DeWitt, Masonic Scholarship, $1,200. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $4,000. Lillian E. James Scholarship, $1,200. And the Red Cross Drive to Serve Scholarship, $250. Trinity Fleek, MVNU Academic Scholarship, $14,000. Kirsten George, K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. Lillian E. James Scholarship, $1,200. And a Purdue University Athletic Scholarship. Ty Landon, First Knox National Bank Hidden Asset Award, $100. Harry A. Mock Scholarship, $500. And the K. Kelly Wilhelm Scholarship, $250. Morgan Lehner, BGSU Freshman Academic Scholarship, $1,000. Jacob Levering, Cardington Lincoln Alumni Association Scholarship, $1,000. John F. Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $2,000. Lillian E. James Scholarship, $1,200. And the FC Bank Scholarship, $500. Nick McAvoy, Heidelberg University Faculty Scholarship, $15,000. Heidelberg University Grant, $5,000. And the Army National Guard Tuition Grant, $17,000. Ashley Morales, MVNU Heritage Scholarship, $16,500. MVNU Diversity Scholarship, $1,000. MVNU Pastor Missionary Dependent Discount, $6,500. MVNU Scholarship, $397. MVNU North Central Ohio District Endowed Scholarship, $1,000. Cardington Lincoln Athletic Scholarship, $500. First Knox National Bank Hidden Asset Award, $100. John M. and Bertha A. Stone Scholarship, $1,500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250, and the Lillian E. James Scholarship, $1,200. Emily Pearl, Cardington FFA Alumni Scholarship, $500. Bryden Ratliff, Stetson University Pre-Contract Scholarship, $55,000. Rihanna Roth, Ohio Northern University Trustee Scholarship, $19,000. Ohio Northern University Grant, $6,400. Ohio Northern University Methodist Crusade Scholarship, $1,000. State of Ohio Choose Ohio First Health Scholarship, $2,500. Beatrice Ann Winchell Kloss Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Carlotta K. Joanne Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Cardington Class of 1970 Scholarship, $2,500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. And the Lillian E. James Scholarship, $1,200. Andrew Shopperai, Marion Technical College Foundation Scholarship, $4,560. Josh Shook, Cardington Lincoln Alumni Association Scholarship, $1,000. Cardington Lincoln Athletic Scholarship, $500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. And Mount Gilead Kiwanis Service Above Self Scholarship, $250. Danny Vaught, Patricia K. Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $2,000. Nicholas Wade, Narco Scholarship, $500. Cardington Lincoln Class of 1970 Trader Technical School Scholarship, $2,500. Liam Warren, Down Home Farm Scholarship, $500. Cardington VOAG Farm Association Scholarship, $750. Cardington Lincoln Athletic Booster Scholarship, $500. Cardington Lincoln FFA Alumni Scholarship, $500. Dorothy Neal Fisher Scholarship, $4,000. Junior Branda Memorial Scholarship, $500. K. Kelly Wilhelm Memorial Scholarship, $250. And the McGinnis Family Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Hannah Wickline, the Beatrice Ann Winchell Kloss Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. In all, our seniors locally have received close to $90,000 in scholarships. Congratulations to them. All in all, the senior class has acquired over $265,000 in scholarships to pursue their college career. Best of luck to all of you. Thank you.
Seniors, rise at this time. Mrs. Clark, I certify that our candidates for graduation meet the requirements set forth by the State of Ohio and the Cardington Lincoln Board of Education and present them to you for graduation.
Thank you, Mr. Mills. On behalf of the Cardington Lincoln Board of Education, I declare that this class of 2020 has met all the requirements set forth by the State Board of Education and the Cardington Lincoln Board of Education. Congratulations.
For the presentation of diplomas, each graduate's family will present Cardington Lincoln High School students their diplomas. Emily Ann Benson. Bailey N. Adams. Ashley Jean Ault. Kaylin Autumn Bailey. Jeffrey A. Barker. Casey Jenna Berkey. Lincoln Brake. Emma Irene Burchett. Madeline Carson Cook. Quentin B. Chalfin. Nicholas Sean Coder. Abigail Jolie DeVore. Chantress Rochelle DeWitt. Tony M. Fickle. Trinity Leanne Fleek. Carly Marie Gaddis. Grace Kristen Strutt. Emily R. Gannon. Kirsten Elena George. Charles Mason Goers. Casey Alexandra Graves. Cody Robert Hyatt. Liz Horton. Skylar Kaler. Ty Jeffrey Landon. Morgan May Lehner. Jacob Robert Levering. Garrett R. Linkus. Nicholas Aiden McAvoy. Ashley Maria Morales. Tristan Nichols. Sierra M. Parsons. Emily Hart Pearl. Bryden Andrew Ratliff. Heidi Aliza Reed. Brianna Marie Roth. Andrew Joseph Chaparai. Lainey Ray Shearborn. Maddie Seitz. Connor W. Shinneberry. Joshua Keith Shook. Cayman Spires. Aaron Stepp. Skyler James Strike. Danny Vaught. Nico Wade. Jasmine Walters. Liam Jeffrey Warren. Hannah Christina Marie Wickline. Kaylee Ann Wood.